إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فإني أحمد الله سبحانه وتعالى وأشكره على أن من علينا بهذه اللقاءات الطيبة المباركة صلى الله أن تكون نافعة للمتكلم وللسامعين آمين. I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we thank Him once again for allowing us to meet with you throughout these classes here, that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be of a great benefit for all of us. Inshallah ta'ala, we continue the topic we spoke about and we started on Friday, Islah al-Qulub, the importance of taking care of our hearts, and we have to check our hearts, because the heart has a great impact on our life, in our lives. وَقَدْ ذَكَرْنَا حَدِيثَ الرَّسُولِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الَّذِي جَاءَ فِيهِ أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةً إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. In a portion of a hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, verily in the body, in the human body is a flesh, morsel of flesh. If it's righteous and upright, the whole body is righteous and upright. But if it's corrupt, that affects the body. People's decisions will be bad, statements, actions, their life not in order, simply because of the condition of the heart. ذكرنا في هذه المحاضرة لفضيلة الشيخ الوالد العلامة صالح بن فوزان الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى وغفر له ولوالديه ولوالدينا والمسلمين والمسلمات أمين أنه لا بد من العناية بالقلب وتنقيته وتطهيره من الذنوب ومن الآثام ومن المعاصي. As we review, alhamdulillah, before we continue, we mention what this noble Shaykh al-Allama, Dr. Salih al-Fawzan bin Fawzan, may Allah preserve him and give him good health and have mercy on himself, on his parents, on our parents, among the Muslims and all the Muslims, ameen. He said that since this is the case, the heart is very important, then we have to take good care of it. We have to purify our hearts and clean our hearts from sins, transgressions, and all acts of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or disobedience to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because the more كُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ الْعَبْدُ فِي الذُّنُوبِ كُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ بُعْدًا عَلِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى كُلَّمَ ازْدَادَ قَلْبُهُ بُعْدًا عَلِ اللَّهِ. We learn that the more a person, a servant of Allah, indulge in sins, transgression, disobedience to Allah, the more that heart is far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَمَا بَالُكَ بِقَلْبْ بَعِيدْ عَنِ اللَّهِ بَعِيدْ عَنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. What do you think now about the condition of a heart that is far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? فَمَا قِبَةُ قَلْبٍ لا ينيب ولا يخشى ولا يرجع ولا يتوب. What is the value of such a heart that does not repent, does not turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seek for forgiveness? آخر ما ذكرنا هو قول الشيخ الناس كلهم يذنبون ولكن الفارق بينهم أن هناك من يبادر إلى ذنبه فيزيله ويطهر قلبه بالتوبة والاستغفار وهناك من هو غافل عن ذنوبه تتراكم على قلبه حتى تهلكه والعياذ بالله. The last point we mentioned on Friday's class is that the Shaykh Hafidahullah, he says, a human being, they sin. We're not perfect. We all have our shortcomings. لكن بين مقلل ومستكثر. Some people, they wrong themselves all the time. They live in sin. Most of what they say is not right. What they eat is not halal. What they drive is from haram. Their clothes is from haram. The job is from haram. Mixing, many things. Other people, alhamdulillah, they mindful, but still, everybody wrong themselves. But what's make a difference is that there are those people who, when they are wrong themselves and they, on a moment of weakness, and they disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do what is wrong, at that moment they feel bad about it. And they feel remorseful. And they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they ask for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They turn to Allah with sincere repentance and ask for forgiveness, and this is how that heart will be cleansed and purified. The same way when a person see a bad stain on his thobe or his carpet or in his car, he want to take care of it immediately, because if he doesn't, it's going to become difficult. It's going to stick harder, and it's going to, if it dries out, and it's going to become difficult to get rid of it. Now you find this type of people, may Allah make us from the mumin. First of all, we ask Allah to protect us from wronging ourselves and from sinning. But we're human. Just in case, if we wrong ourselves, we should be from these people here, that they hasten to do something about it. At least I should acknowledge that what I said was not right, what I've done was not something that is pleasing to Allah. This decision I'm about to make is bad for me in this life, and of course it's not going to be good on Yom Qiyamah, and I'm about to do something about it to correct it for the better. But then there are other people who are heedless. They don't care, like we say. They commit a sin after sin, they plan sins, and it's all the same to them. It's okay. And therefore, they do not repent, they don't ask forgiveness, and those sins, they continue to pile up on their hearts until they destroy them. The Prophet ﷺ said in a sound hadith, كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون. Prophet ﷺ, معلم الناس الخير, the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to teach mankind all good. He says, all of the children of Adam make mistakes, wrong themselves, commit sins. But the best of those who commit sins are those who repent afterwards. So he didn't say the best of Bani Adam, خير بني آدم الذين لا يخطئون. ما قال هذا. Okay? So it's very important. The Prophet ﷺ, he didn't say the best of the children of Adam and those who don't sin. He says all of the children of Adam wrong themselves by sinning. But the best amongst them are those who repent afterwards. Immediately, once they wrong themselves and commit a sin, they want to do something about it. They know immediately that what they've done is wrong. What they said is wrong. Whether they wrong themselves by neglecting one of the obligations, or drinking something haram, or eating something haram, or touching something they have no business to touch, or looking at something that they shouldn't, or listening to something, or also when they wrong others. When they say something bad to somebody, or about somebody, or damage someone's property, or betray trust, or he was entrusted with a job and he didn't do it as the contract says, or he is a tenant in somebody's house and he trashed it. Whatever the case, he's like, subhanAllah, I was wrong. That was me. And this happened between parents, between husband and wife, between a father and a son, between a daughter and this, as we're going to learn later on. But then he will go, that husband will go to his wife and say, you know what, this morning I was wrong. That was me. And I apologize. Alhamdulillah, she's going to be very happy with that. Same thing. the wife, she would send a beautiful text message. She apologized. It's like, look, I didn't know what happened. I just, it's not worth it. But I said what I said, and I was wrong. And things go back to normal. نعم إذن علينا عباد الله من الأمور الحمد لله التي تساعد على تنقية القلوب هي الاستغفار والتوبة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. One of the main things that help us clean our hearts is repentance, to repent from sins and to seek forgiveness from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وباب الاستغفار والتوبة مفتوح. And we should know from the mercy of Allah upon us that the door of Tawbah and for forgiveness is always open. It is not open only on Ramadan or only on Friday or only in Hajj. It's not open only for the rich or the Arabs or this or that. It's open for everybody who wants to repent and for anyone who wants forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The door is open. Allah accepts the repentance. All we need to do is to ask for it. That's as easy as that. But some people, they don't even, as easy as it is, you don't have to pay no money, you don't have to wait for Ramadan, you don't have to go to Arafah, you don't have to spend a dime. All you have to do, be sincere, because Allah knows what's in the hearts. إذن يقول الشيخ لننقي قلوبنا من أقذار الذنوب التي تتابع علينا كل يوم. Subhanallah, we live in this life. Subhanallah, we're surrounded by so many bad things. There's a lot of things that are pulling us away from the path that Allah has chosen for us. So we should be more mindful that we should make tawbah a lot, and we should ask forgiveness all time. Otherwise, subhanallah, these sins, they're going to pile up on you, and they become a burden on you, and you cannot bear it, and you cannot carry it, and then it's going to become a problem for you. نحن مدعوون من رب كريم إلى التوبة والاستغفار لنجلي تلك القلوب من أثقالها التي تحول بيننا وبين الطمأنينة والسكينة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of His mercy, being merciful to us, wanting good for us, He's calling us, inviting us to repent. He's inviting us to seek His forgiveness. He's inviting us so that we can purify our hearts from the burden and the weight, the heavy weight that comes, that is the result of sins that comes between us and tranquility and peace and ease. How many people, subhanAllah, are looking for ease and tranquility and peace of mind? They cannot find it. They may be rich, have a lot of money, lives in mansions, drives, subhanAllah, cars that we can even say right, the name, not alone come up with the price. We don't even know the name of certain cars, not alone the price, from vacation to vacation, but they have no tranquility, no peace of mind whatsoever. You cannot buy happiness. You cannot buy joy and tranquility and serenity. The tranquility of the heart comes with the remembrance of Allah. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. You may buy the most expensive mattress in the world, but it's not guaranteed that it will come with one good night of sleep. Tranquility is the tranquility of the heart. Sins come between a person and that tranquility and that ease and peace of mind. If you wonder about the nurse, مشاكل نفسية خاصة في هذه الأيام في عصرنا هذا عنده مشاكل نفسية ومشاكل عائلية بين الزوجين بين الأب وابنه والأم وابنتها بين الإخوة وبين الأحبة ما سببها؟ البعد عن الله والمعاصي. هذا هو السبب. Now you find people going through a lot of difficulties. People are suffering from anxiety, right? Stress. Psychological problems. subhanAllah, marital issues, problems in the family, husband and wife and children and parents, grandparents, cousins, they're supposed to love one another and help one another and assist one another and care for one another, because that's what is the way it's supposed to be, but they don't. Certain families, they don't have it like that. Nothing but fighting and turmoil, backbiting and gossip and slander, chaos. Problems between husband and wife, they're supposed to, mashallah, because remember, the day when they married, they weren't married while they're fighting. Right or wrong? Have you ever seen a husband and a wife, the first day when they married, they fighting each other? She's going to tell him, listen, brother, we're fighting right now, you go home, I'm going home. No, everybody's happy, everybody showed their best on the first day of marriage, right? A wife can't be the same. Should be the same, and should be even better. Try to make it better, and remember, say, look, we're human. There is no marriage that is problem-free. But we just have to face these problems and see who's right is right and who's wrong is wrong. Let's be honest. That's what a husband should say to his wife, and a wife should remind her husband. Constantly, look, we're human beings. I'm a man, you're a woman. That's enough as a difference. I'm not going to expect you to act as a man, and you're not going to expect me to act as a woman. So you're the woman, I'm the man. So you do the thing that Allah has made obligatory upon you. I'm going to try my best to do those things as well. But look, we're human. One day I'm going to say things that you don't like. One day you're going to say things that I don't approve of. But you're still my wife and I'm still your husband. And if we're real in this marriage and we care about it and the children, then we're not going to stop it, you know. And then you go this way for the first problem. No, we're going to face the problem and we're going to be, the man is going to be man enough and going to be honest and say, you're right. You're right, that was me. I wasn't thinking and I apologize. Now, problems, ikhwan, between in the communities, problems at work, problems between neighbors. Why? One of the main reasons is people are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're not obedient to Allah. Their life is not around the deen of Allah and applying the deen of Allah. Sins and disobedience to Allah. That's what behind the sins, problems and chaos, sins. One of the Salaf, he used to say, إِنِّي لَأَعْرِفُ الذَّنْبَ إِذَا أَذْنَبْتُ. He used to say, I really know when I commit a sin. He says, because I see the impact of the sin. أَرَى ذَلِكَ فِي خُلُقِ زَوْجَتِي وَدَابَّتِي. He said, I see the impact of the sin in the behavior of my wife and my riding beast. When his animal that, or whatever it is, a horse, a camel, a donkey, start giving him hard time, he don't blame the camel or the... He's like, wait a minute. This camel was going fine. I must have done wrong. When his wife start to give him hard time, he don't stand there and fight her and call her names. No, he's like, wait a minute. It's not about her. It's about me. I must have done something wrong, because this woman, when I left in the morning, she was nice to me. She gave me a hug and made dua, said, may Allah protect you, please come back safe to us. Now she's tripping. Why? I must have done something wrong, subhanAllah. That's why she's acting like that. أَيْنَ نَحْنُ مِنْ هَوْلَىٰ. So this is very important, Yaquan. People, they've been looking for, subhanAllah, the cure. I don't know where. Some people, those who have anxiety, stress, depression, man, they go to some specialist and a lot of money and put them on some narcotic, on some drugs. That costs a lot of money and make it even worse for them. Whereas the cure is free and guarantees, min Rabbil Alameen, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, change your life. Give up sins. Be a servant of Allah. Instead of following your desires and eat what you want, listen to what you want, look to what you want, do what you want, go whatever you want, then you're like, myself and of Allah. I have to protect myself and protect my heart. I gotta do what Allah commands me to do because Allah has chosen for me what's better for me. Yeah, subhanAllah, you can't just put anything in your heart. Do you put anything in your gas tank in the car? Huh? You're driving a nice car, you just put olive oil, bleach, water in a tank, is that car going to function? It's not going to function, it's going to give you a hard time. Likewise, if we don't put in our hearts Tawheed and Sunnah and the good manners of Islam, we're going to have problems. We're going to have problems. If we listen to anybody or read anything or think anything is going to work, not anything is going to work. Allah is the one who created us and He knows what works for us. That's why out of His mercy He legislates for us things. Do these things that are good for you. SubhanAllah, when you come to the dunya, we all know that. Everything that you buy come with a what?
Instructional manual.
The car, the phone, the fridge, juicer, whatever. And then before you put it together, or if you want to benefit from it, you follow what? The instructions. You don't just throw the instruction away and say, I'm going to do it my way. It's not going to work. It's not. If we're looking for happiness and joy and as individuals, and if we're looking at progress and might and power as a communities and as ummah, it's not going to happen like that. It's going to happen the same way it happened to the Sahaba, who was the only few, and they ruled the universe. The only few coming from the Bedouins and from the desert, but they wipe out major dynasties, Persia, Romans, name it, at that time. How did they do it? With tanks and missiles? No, they did it with Tawheed, Ikhlas, sincerity. They hold on firm to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala address us, subhanAllah, in the most beautiful way. Shows mercy and kindness. Saying Surah Al-Zumar, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, say, O my servants who has wronged themselves with sin, commit a lot of sins, say to them, never despair of the mercy of Allah. It's never too late. Death, if you die, yes, can do nothing when you die. You're still alive, never ever despair of the mercy of Allah. Why? Because Allah says, Allah forgive all sins. There is not a sin that Allah cannot forgive. Allah forgive all sins. Even if someone is a mushrik, a panshirk, and worship I don't know what, animals, and he went and worshiped everything else besides Allah, and he came to one of us, we say, hey, Allah forgive all sins. Even shirk, I used to worship Jesus. Allah will forgive you. Somebody say he killed somebody. He's doing this. He was stealing. He was. You can just say yes. Allah forgive all sins. Just have to be sincere. And of course, if that sin involves other people, then there is certain conditions and details that person should know. Of course, this is not the time to talk about that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all sins. Why? Because He is Al-Ghafoor Al-Rahim, the most forgiving, the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we learn from this that ourselves, we should never despair from the mercy of Allah. Because shaitan has plans and his tricks. He may come to you and say, oh, this sin is, you're done. Come on, man. This is it. It's over for you. No, it's never over for you. Never. As long as you breathe, it's never too late. Always turn to Allah and ask Allah for forgiveness. And also help us to explain this matter to others. Sometimes you find somebody depressed, very down. What happened? I don't want to talk about it. What is it? Man, he says or she said they commit the biggest sin. To them is the biggest sin. That is it. And they feel that. Some people, they even go kill themselves. Because they feel at that moment that this is it, they have no life, and they go and even committed another great sin, which is suicide, intihar. You tell them, no. Don't worry, don't let the shaitan fool you. Alhamdulillah, doesn't matter what you commit. Shirk is the greatest of all sins. There is nothing greater than shirk. Allah forgive it for those who turn to Allah with tawheed. Allah forgive them. If they sincere and they want to worship Allah, alhamdulillah, Allah forgive them. So don't. Just turn to Allah and alhamdulillah, be a good servant of Allah, practice Islam correctly, and you will see the difference in your life. نعم عباد الله نحن مدعوون من رب رحيم أن نستغفره ونتوب إليه يقول ربنا عز وجل من يعمل سوءا أو يظلم نفسه ثم يستغفر الله يجد الله غفور رحيم سورة النساء. We are invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is merciful to us. Allah is calling us so that we turn to Him and seek His forgiveness, and we repent to Him from our sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and whoever does or commit a sin or wrong himself and therefore seek forgiveness, he will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ghafoor and raheem, that Allah will forgive him their sins and merciful. Allahu Akbar. What else we want, ya ikhwan, more than this? Just between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to come to the imam of the masjid, because this is not the right way. Not like the Christian, they have to go and confess to the priest only to hold it against them one of those days. You don't have to confess to anybody. Just do it between you and Allah. Stand up at night and pray a couple of rak'at and say, oh Allah, in your sujood, oh Allah, you know what I've done. I did it. I'm reckless, ignorant. Please forgive me and protect me. I don't want to do it again. I'm struggling with this. I don't want to do it again. Please protect me and polish my heart and purify my soul. هكذا. الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويعفو عن السيئات ويعلم ما تفعلون كما قال في سورة الشورى. It is He, Allah, who accepts repentance from His servants and forgive and pardon sins, and He knows what you do. And He knows what you do. Our noble Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us in the hadith that is collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih. Hadith أخرجه الإمام مسلم رحمه الله في الصحيح. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها. الله أكبر. بشارة عظيمة. Allah extends His hands at night, of course, in a manner that befits His Majesty سبحانه وتعالى. لا نكيف نقول كيف ولما لا أبدا تبت صفة تبتت نثبتها. If we have a name or attributes that are affirmed for Allah, whether in the Quran or in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, we affirm that for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without asking how or resembling it to the attributes of creation, but we believe. Here Allah extends His hand at night so that the sinner of the day asks for repentance. Allahu Akbar. Likewise, Allah extends His hand at night, a day, so that the sinner at night asks for forgiveness. And this continues until the sun rises from the west. That's one of the major signs of the hour. when the sun rises from the west. Now we all see that the sun rises from the east and sets in the west. But one of the major signs of the hour, and also this is the Prophet ﷺ tells us that if that happened, no more tawbah. That's it. People, they will ask, oh, astaghfirullah, la ilaha illallah, Allah will not accept from them. So Allah salam alayhi. فما موقفك أيها العبد الضعيف من هذا الوعد الكريم من رب العالمين؟ So what is our position now as we bring in the ayahs and the hadith? What is our position now? We the weak ones, we sin, we transgress, we wrong ourselves. What are we going to do with this great promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this kindness of Allah? Allah is willing to forgive us. Where are we? Why aren't we asking for forgiveness? Why are we begging Allah for forgiveness? أخي الكريم أختي الكريمة هل نحن ممن يفزع إلى الله بالتوبة والاستغفار أم أننا نرتكب الذنب وننسى حتى يصبح رينا يغطي القلوب؟ Are we now from those who run to Allah سبحانه وتعالى? They turn back to Allah with sincere repentance and asking for forgiveness? Or are we going to be from those who they just continue to commit sins and wrong themselves? They even forget about the sins until they become a black cavern on their hearts. قال الشيخ كم ذكرنا لكم عباد الله إننا نهتم بنظافة ثيابنا وبيوتنا وسياراتنا ونبادر إلى إزالة أي أقدار بها ولو كلفنا الشيء الكثير من المال والوقت. We as a human being, we care about our cleanliness, our clothing. We all want to make sure that our clothing are clean, our homes are clean, our cars are clean. And if we see any filth or stains, we want to take care of it immediately. Even though it may cost money and a lot of time to do that, are we going to do it? لا يجرؤ أحد منا الخروج أمام الناس بثياب قذرة. None of us have the audacity to come in front of the people with filthy, stinky clothing. He's not going to go. He may stay home until they wash, if that's the only thing he has. لا يغفل الناس عن تعاهد بيوتهم بل يستحيون من استضافة أي أحد حتى ينظف البيت أليس كذلك؟ نعم بلى هو كذلك. People, they constantly cleaning their homes, their apartments, their houses, but rather some people, they want to bring somebody in the house, but then they're like, oh, you know what, I just remember. They may even lie and say, oh, I remember I have an appointment. You can't come today. Why? Because the house is a mess. How many of us invite somebody in the house, but then he called his wife or his daughter or whatever. Is the house clean? They say, why? Somebody's coming. And they run, right wrong. They all of them run and clean the house. Why? Because somebody is coming. They don't want the person, that guest, which is a good thing, to come and socks everywhere and food all over the place and trash, you know? No, they want to clean the house. قال الشيخ ليتنا نفعل ذلك بقلوبنا. أي ننظف سياراتنا, بيوتنا, ثيابنا. فما بال القلب؟ القلب يحتاج إلى تطهير, إلى طهارة, إلى نظافة. قلوبنا أحوج إلى هذه المتابعة والغسل والتنقية. Our hearts are more deserving of this cleanliness and purification from sins, from transgression, from ignorance, from bid'ah, innovations. لا يضر الشخص يا أخي لا يضر الشخص ثوبه إذا كان قلبه نقيا نظيف. Wearing a dirty clothing is not going to harm you as long as your heart is pure and clean. ولا قيمة للثوب متى كان القلب قذرا عفنا بالذنوب والمعاصي. Sparkling clean clothing or thobe It's not going to help person Yawm al-Qiyamah if that person meet Allah with a filthy heart, with sins, wal-iyadu billah, and disobedience. As we narrate to you the statement of one of the Salaf, قَلْبٌ نَقِيٌّ فِي ثِيَابٍ دَنِسَةٍ خَيْرٌ مِنْ قَلْبٍ دَنِسٍ فِي ثِيَابٍ نَقِيَّةٍ قَلْبٌ نَقِيٌّ فِي ثِيَابٍ دَنِسَةٍ خَيْرٌ مِنْ قَلْبٍ دَنِسٍ فِي ثِيَابٍ نَقِيَّةٍ A pure heart, even though the person is in filthy clothing, is much better than a filthy heart that is in clean clothing. Jazakallah khair. Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. Now, أليس لنا في رسول الله أسوة وقدوة يا إخوان؟ أجيبوا. ها؟ أليس لنا؟ أجيب. قل بلى. ليس نعم. بلى. Don't we have in the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم the best example? Who can answer?
Yes.
I know. Indeed. Indeed. He's the example. The word the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Who is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? What can you say about him? Tell me something about him.
Abdul Khair
al-Masaleem. Khairu khalqillah. Khairu al-khalq.
Abdul Khalq
al-Azim. But what the Messenger of Allah used to say and used to do? Sahih Muslim. يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أيها الناس توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه. أيها الناس ونحن من الناس. هذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم معلم الناس الخير يريد لنا الخير ما من خير إلا وذل الأمة عليه يقول يا أيها الناس أيها الناس توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه فإني أتوب إلى الله في اليوم 100 مرة معصوم من الذنوب وخير خلق الله يتوب والواحد منا الله المستعان ما يتوب 100 يوم ربما تمر ما تاب ولا مرة واحد Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he says O people repent to Allah turn to Allah from disobedience to obedience and seek forgiveness from him for indeed I the messenger of Allah I turn to Allah with repentance 100 times a day Some of us 100 days go by here and ask Allah for forgiveness once. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هذا هو الطريق. Don't grow arrogant. I didn't do nothing. That's not a big deal. You guys just making it too difficult. You making it difficult. Some people when somebody say, يا أخي هذا حرام ولا يصلح لك ولا نتائجه وخيمة كذا يقول أنت تحسدني الربا الآن كيف أحسدك على الربا كيف أحسدك على الربا أحسدك على الزنا نحسدك على الغيبة والنميمة You find a person الله المستعان ممن لم يوفى those people who Allah didn't give them tawfiq to see their sins and to try to do something about it You find them committing sins, and when somebody tells them, yeah, leave this stuff, this hour, you're just jealous. Sometimes a person has a business that is based on haram, liquors, cigarettes, dachis, I don't know what, and he's making money, and he thinks they're making good money. When someone tells him, yeah, you gotta leave this stuff alone. Why? You have gas station and milk and bread and eggs. Why you mix it with dutchies and why? And liquors. Why? Why are you mixing haram with halal? Ah, you're a hater. You hate me and you're jealous because you're not making the money I'm making. Person go and get a house from riba, usury wal-iyadu billah. And he knows it's haram or driving a car like that. And when a person wants good for him, say, yeah, this is not going to help you in Yawm al-Qiyamah. this house of riba, that's not going to help you in Yawm al-Qiyamah. It's going to have a bad impact on yourself, on your children, in this life. Leave it alone, ya akhi. Paying rent is halal in Islam. Paying rent is halal. Pay what you can. But buying a house with mortgage and with riba, that's haram. Allah says He raged war against those people. You can't stand no war against Allah and His Messenger, or something. Instead of the person say, Jazakallah khair, yeah, you're right, I know that, but I've done this long time ago and I'm still looking for a solution how to get out of this. Please, do you know anything? Anybody from the ulama can help me? I know, I've done this when I was ignorant. How can I get out of this? Now you find a person grow arrogant, you say, yeah, you're just a hater, you just, because you can't do it, because you have a bad credit and the bank didn't approve you, that's why you're jealous. How am I going to be jealous against someone that Allah raged war against? And many things, there is many other examples. Person have bad manners, cheating the people, harming them in so many ways, and then when he's approached and say, Tub ila Allah, repent to Allah, ya akhi, Tub, istaghfir. No, I'm strong, you're weak, you can't do nothing. I'm strong, man, I got a better position in the community, I'm going to use that position because people have to fear me. I'm not going to be weak like you. That's how they look at the strength. Disobeying Allah, that's no strength. That's weakness. That's weakness right there. So may Allah make us from those who, when they hear the speech, they follow it. And they adhere to it. Bi-idhnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam, ya akhwan. La budda. Hada huwa alladhi sayinfa'una. At-tawba. Al-inaba ila Allah. Al-istighfar. Dhikrullah. Hadi hiya as-siyana al-mustamira lil-qalb. Siyana, ya akhi. Maintenance. الإنسان صيانة السيارة الزيت والمراقبة والإطارات وما أدري إيش ولا لا سبحان الله this is the thing that's gonna help us maintain our hearts correctly in a better position repentance turning to Allah asking forgiveness remembrance of Allah you have to maintain your heart same way you maintain your car man right wrong Look at the people. They rotate the seats. I mean the tires. They change the oil, right? Every 30,000 miles.
Every 10,000,
5,000. 3,000, man. Who says 10,000? What new car you guys driving? My car says 3,000.
That's the old cars, no?
Old cars. Okay, I don't know. I speak with wine now. Alright, 10,000 for older cars, for newer cars. But you know what I'm talking about? You get the point. People, they rotate tires, change oil, check all fluids,
change filters,
pay attention to the advice of the mechanic, right wrong? When the mechanic say your brakes are coming low, you gotta check your brakes. Do they tamper with things like this? Do they neglect the advice of the mechanic? They don't. They go and do it. Even if they may have money for something else, but they're going to go fix it. But we, subhanAllah, we have so many reminders in our lives. Ayat we hear in the khutbahs. We attend khutbah jumu'ah, and we hear so many ayat. But we have to come. See, the difference is that you have to come prepared. Before you come for jumu'ah, you're going to say, Alhamdulillah, this imam here, he always is an imam upon sunnah. Inshallah, he usually address us, I'm only one of the people. I'm gonna go prepared. Whatever he throw at me, like we can say that, I'm gonna be ready. And you come ready. Not just come whenever you wanna come to Jumu'ah and sit in the back with the phone. Some people even Jumu'ah, the khutbah is on, they're talking. Not even, no, now you gotta come and say, look, whatever I'm gonna hear today, it's for me. I'm gonna hear an ayah because this khutbah here, what is about? قال الله قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم Sahaba said, this ulama of the Salaf upon Sunnah, they said, things that you need to hear and I need to hear. But I have to come prepared and say, Inshallah, oh Allah, help me so I can benefit from this khutbah of today, inshallah. So I'm paying attention. I prepared myself. I cleaned. I free myself. My mind, my heart is ready. Ayah, subhanAllah. The Imam is talking, but I'm like, subhanAllah, that ayah is for me. The other ayah too. The hadith, most definitely. I was looking for a hadith like that. And then before the khutbah is over, you already make a decision. You feel guilty about certain things and happy about others. The bad thing that you've done, now there is a solution for them, how you correct them. The good things you've been doing, you know, you thank Allah. So I have to be grateful to Allah that I'm doing some good things. I'm alhamdulillah, I'm not like all bad, bad, bad stuff. But still I have to do something about that bad things I've been doing. Because that's not going to help me in my grave. And most definitely, I don't want to see that in Yawm al-Qiyamah when I stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet, yes, you can. You might not see that. If you get rid of it today by repenting and turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking for forgiveness. Now, subhanAllah, like he says, we oil change and maintaining the house. Why you do all this, for example? You change oil, you maintain the car, just so you can enjoy the ride, right? Huh? You're not gonna enjoy a ride with the problems. Likewise, you wanna enjoy your stay in this life? Maintain your heart. No shirk, tawheed, no bid'ah, sunnah. Bad akhlaq, I'm going to try to get rid of them, inshallah. Even if it takes me some time, I'm willing to do it. If I'm wrong and somebody approach me, I'm going to say, Jazakallah khair. Yes, I'm wrong. You're right. And bad things, even though some bad habits, I'm willing to change. Doesn't matter how long it takes me. At least I'm willing to change those bad habits. This was going to help us, Yahuwah, so we can enjoy our stay in this life, and yet we can see the great fruits and when we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yutahhira qulubana. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yu'inana ala tanqiyati qulubina wa tathhiriha min al-dunub wal-athan wal-ma'asi. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and assist us so that we can clean and purify our hearts and our souls from sins and disobedience. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so Allah an yaghfir lana wa lakum al-dhunub wal-khataya. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wafaqana wa iyaakum al-ilm al-nafi' al-muthmir al-amal al-salih. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yatajawaza anna wa an yaghfir lana wa an yuthabbitana wa iyaakum ala sunnah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam taslima kathira.